A very good morning to all of you. This is the lecture number 8 for the subject switchgear and protection. So in today's topic we are going to discuss regarding the voltage balance differential relay. So in our previous lectures we had discussed many relays named as induction type overcurrent relay, directional as well as bidirectional, induction type power relay, bidirectional in impedance or distance relays. So all these relays, there is one thing in common: they all operate whenever there is a rise in the value of the current. So the relay operates and the circuit breaker trips, and the contacts of the circuit breakers open, which remove the faulty section from the healthy section. So all these relays work only on when the current exceeds the predetermined value. So to overcome this drawback, these relays are not sufficient to distinguish between the heavy load conditions fault and light load conditions fault. To overcome this drawback, there is another category of relays which we are discussing. Those are the differential relay. In the previous lecture, we had discussed regarding the current differential relay. In this lecture, we will discuss regarding the voltage differential relay. So voltage differential relay in figure 1, which is drawn here. Figure 1, which is drawn here, shows the arrangement for a voltage differential relay. So what we are doing here, we had taken the winding of the alternator. Alternator is basically a generator of the AC category. Okay, AC generators are also known as alternators. So in this particular topic, we are protecting the alternating winding from the fault. So that in the case of fault, due to any reason, it may be due to the unsymmetrical fault, it may be due to short circuit fault, in case of any type of fault, the relay operating coil sense and it will operate the trip circuit, which in turn opens the contacts of the circuit breaker. So here is the alternator winding. At the both ends of the alternator winding, it is provided with the current transformers. Both ends of this winding is provided with the current transformers. This is current transformer 1 and this is current transformer 2. So these two current transformers, one side is earth and the another side is connected to the load. So there are two currents that is flowing across the current transformer, that is I1 and I2. So this is the relay operating coil, this is the EMF induced. So under the normal operating conditions, the value for the current I1 equals to the value for the current I2, and the EMF induced both on both the sides will be of equal magnitude. So both the EMFs are in equal magnitude, therefore there is no current flows across the relay operating coil, and the relay will and the relay contacts will remain in the off position. Okay. So whenever there is a fault, okay, due to that fault, the values of the current. Whenever there is a fault, during the fault, what happens? During the fault, what happens? The value of the current and the at the both ends of the transformer gets changed. Due to that change in the current, EMF induced also gets changed. Okay. Due to the change in induced EMF on both the ends, there is a current flowing through the relay operating coil. When current flows through the relay operating coil, it closes the contacts of the trip circuit, which in turn opens the contacts of the circuit breaker. Relay operating coil क्या करेगा कि trip contacts को close कर देगा trip circuit के, और which in turn opens the contacts of the circuit breaker, which remove this alternator from the healthy portion of the system so that our system will remain in synchronism. So this is what all is explained in all this theory. All this stuff is explained in this theory. So similar, all these things are explained already under healthy conditions. The current flowing I1 equals to I2 flows in both primary windings. Therefore, the secondary voltages of the two transformers are balanced against each other and no current will flow through the relay operating point. So when a fault occurs in the, all these things I had explained in my conversation just now. So what this is the important concept. What are the disadvantages? So this is somehow important. What are the disadvantages? We know that there is advantage of differential relays. They can distinguish between the light load fault conditions and heavy load fault conditions. So everything has a pros and cons in a parallel similar manner. So there are two disadvantages which they find out. A multi-gap transformer construction is required. After a certain gap, one more transformer is connected to achieve accurate balance between transformer pair. So a multi-gap, due to this multi-gap nature of construction, this is one of the major drawback of the voltage differential relay. And the second category is the system is suitable for protection of cables of relatively short lengths due to the capacitance of pilot wires. So pilot wires are the wires which are connected between the two, these are the pilot wires. So pilot wires are making the connection across the two current transformers and the alternator winding. So you can see easily here the secondary side of the current transformer is in series with the relay operating coil. So all these connections are made through the use of pilot wires, as in this case the secondaries of two current transformers are in series with relay operating coil. Okay. So on long cables, the charging current may be sufficient to operate the relay even if a perfect balance of current transformer is attained. So these are the few major drawbacks for the voltage balance differential relay. So due to these drawbacks, there is another category of relay in the another lecture which we are going to discuss in detail, that is the translay modified balance system. So translay is basically the modified version of the balanced voltage system. ठीक है, so हम this is my 8th lecture. तो हम पूरे 8th lectures में हम relays का ही discuss कर रहे हैं. तो कुछ relays में drawbacks निकल रहे हैं जिसके कारण कुछ advanced features की relays हम step by step discuss कर रहे हैं. कुछ जो drawbacks हमें पीछे निकले डिस्टेंस इम्पीडेंस रिलेज में और इंडक्शन टाइप रिलेज में, उसको ओवरकम करने के लिए हमने रिलेज यूज़ की डिफरेंशियल रिले. जो डिफरेंशियल रिले के ड्रॉबैक्स हैं उसको ओवरकम करने के लिए हम स्टडी करेंगे ट्रांसले स्कीम. सो थैंक यू गाइस, दैट इज ऑल रिगार्डिंग टुडे सेशन.